Yeah, we met Sephiron in the tower. He told us he was behind literally everything we've ever done. Because he wanted the world vanquished. And we're gonna hop into the fight, I think. I don't think we did. Let's go to outfit. No supports. Ina and Kurth can get to A support. And if Sanaki, all right, so Sanaki and Lyre will never reach their A support. Lucia and Volke reaches their A support. But the most we can get with Lyre and Sanaki is B. What an asshole, pretty much though. Let's see, award experience. Micaiah, please. Did you really stop at 99? We got speed. Yes. Yes, Micaiah. Yes. Alright, so. Let's see, Brom hit level 20. Boyd. Let's get Ina 99. Just for some help. Is Lyre time. Sothe, have a level. Can make a rainbow without Lyre. That's, you're right. Right. That wasn't a good level, but thanks, Sothe. Well, now you have, I don't think he had all that cap before, but I don't remember. Oh, Kurth has cap strength and speed. Oh, he has 5 levels to go. I just realized that. Boyd. Do I want to give you? No. I'll let you have your last 2 levels. You've been pretty decent on levels. Micaiah, I can get you level 10. Which I think I'm gonna do. Might as well. What is this? What time is it? Wait, what? Rain. I can't watch anymore. That was enough. That was too much. 40 magic. Look at you, capping magic, Micaiah. We good on skills. Sanaki does not need Paragon anymore. But Rain, isn't that the dude from Xenoblade Chronicles? Before I give you anything, let's see here. Okay. Dragon Foe, I don't need anymore. We are done with Dragon Foe. Can't handle that. I could not. Not when it's paired with High School Musical. No, I cannot. Oh, well, let's get to that here in a second. Sanaki, we'll give you, do we want to give, can nullify the effects of an enemy unit's attack? Sure, take Pavis, you're really squishy. And Leonardo, but she's not capping speed, she's absolutely not capping speed. Leonardo, Nihil? Yeah, you can have Nihil. And then remove Savior. Give you Neil. Volke. Oh, you have Nihil. You're gonna need Nihil. Well, are you? Well, I don't have that many Nihils. Never mind. Ike really is the only one who needs to survive. So Kurth does not need his Laguz gem anymore, so we can give that to Ina. And we don't need grass anymore, but you know, I'll just keep it there for shits. Lyre, you good. Any fresh waters just sitting in here that I can take? There's that. Take the elixirs. Alright. Okay, so this map is very, very reliant on the floor. There's wardwood, cover, super covers. But we're fighting wind spirits that have a movement of 20. So pretty much, if you don't make a straight wall with your... I mean, this only really matters if we had Leanne. If you don't make an impassable wall with your units across the map and have Leanne in the back, she's going to be attacked. And these ones next to them, or let's see, do they have a skill? No, they don't have skills. They have 40 HP. They do elemental damage. They all have about the same. Well, I mean, each different element has its own stats. Come back just in time. Yes, we just getting started here. But is it Sephiroth that has a skill that does it, or is it just... No, he doesn't have a skill that does it. So these guys will take Sephiroth's, like, damage into themselves. Like instead of me killing Sephiroth, I'll kill one of these because they're right next to him. So they're just kind of, like, passing the damage through. Kind of annoying. But I definitely... They're all magic, aren't they? Pretty sure they're all magic based. I can go on Wardwoods. Oh yeah, Purge Tome. Forgot you had that. About to give it back. Let me take it if you are dealing enough damage. Yeah. Okay, Danved. You have Vladimir right now instead of, oh yeah, because I forgot to move, like, everything back. Holy shit. Is this the wind one? Yeah. I want to see how much you're going to do. Well, it shouldn't matter, actually. Because you have Nullify. Alright. And there are not any map animations for fighting these things. Or not map, full-on battle animations. There's map animations, but that's all. That's all we get. Oh, this is the super, super cover tile right there. Which I will probably put Ike on top of. Actually, no, he needs to be on a Wardwood. There isn't super Wardwood, is there? I don't believe there is. There's Healstone. No, this is the super defense one. Put you on a Wardwood. Kill this thing. Might as well just turn him off. No, cause when we fight Sephiroth, I want the animations to play. Let me just make sure they are. Yeah, they are on. Ina, you kind of suck. Have a Goose Gem. And stand on that. Peshkatz. That is, in fact, a kill. I really didn't remember that. Granted, I usually play this game with map animations only for... map animations only for the map. I think I did that for my LP, just because in an LP setting... It's kind of needed. Because Fire Emblem's already not the quickest paced game. And especially in this game, where the map animations take forever. Lyre. Don't fuck up the spirits, Lyre. No, not this turn, you don't. Because you are not a cat this turn. There you go. Oprah, how we do? Not great. Not great. What are you on? You're on a cover tile, that's why. Okay. This game has map animation still faster than... Still faster than Path of Radiance, yes. But... Still not the fastest thing ever. Zero percent hit. Let's go. I forgot the Alanda. I could have moved back one. Oops. Oh, she's on Healstone. It's not terrible. Sanaki. Could have conversed. Oh, well. Void. Don't know if that's a good spot for you. But... We're doing what we can, I suppose. Let's do some damage, if we even hit. If we don't. Leo. Alright, so... You can see, like, there's... I left one spot open. I mean, 20 gets them pretty far, but they can reach the entire map because I left one spot open. I'm gonna chill out right there. Okay. Hello. Boyd is going to be your... Oh, shit. Yeah, Boyd, we might be resetting already because Boyd is going to be targeted by all of them. Yep. Oh. Are we gonna make it out of this? We probably won't. Wait. Wait. I don't think the rest of them move. Sephiron, why... I didn't even remember you could do this. Ugh. Why do you gotta ruin everything? We would've lived 2 HP. See, the Lakus and Bjork have doomed each other with their mutual hatred. You have brought extinction on yourselves. God damn it. I just let him die. It's the second- No, I can't let him die. If it was the last map, sure. Second last, nope. Last map, people are allowed to die. This map, no. They're not. Alright. So, let's do that again. Let's put Boyd... on Wardwood. Under. He did good, and then Sephiron was like, nah. Nah, you ain't getting out. Can I double? No, can't kill you there. Ina. I think I'm also going to do this. I'm gonna ward Boyd. Just to be even more safe. He's on Wardwood. With a ward up. We should be fine. Why can't I kill you now? What? What is this? What is this? Were you not the one I killed? Was it this one that I went to kill? What? Whatever. Get bodied, little spirit. Get run up on. Lucia. Fire, yes. Okay. Danved, can you do anything? You can. You can, actually. I think... Oh, no. No, that's Wardwood. Put you on a heal stone. Kill you with the Wishblade. Okay. No, I'll stay here. Why not? You have max res, don't you? Yeah. You can be on a cover as well. Fuck it. Kurth. Then Ina. Converse because you can. And then Lagoose Gem. Get that Blood Tide going. Sanaki. Or not Sanaki, but Titania. You can catch a Wardwood. Yeah, equip the have that equip, I don't care. Draining Dawn, the only game with a draft, or are there other... You can make a draft with, like, almost every game. So you go here because I said so. Is that... It's almost a perfect wall. And now... It is a perfect wall. Look at that. And then there's Soth doing the best. Like in this game, there's a tower where you can only choose 10 units. That's what the draft is. I mean, it's just the units you used for the final map. It's however that... Okay, okay. How much is this gonna do? ...20 damage to Brom. Okay. Is Brom their target now? No, Danved's their target now. Okay. Another game with a similar mechanic. I have heard one of the Game Boy games has a similar ending. Oh my god, Soth. Did you really just do zero... Oh, because you have a silver knife equipped. That explains it. Oh wait, are these things... Can I only hit these things with enchanted weapons? I don't even remember. But I guess they don't have any skills. But that must be it. You're just ganging up on Soth. Poor Soth. Don't have mana. I know that, but like he actually just didn't do damage. Oh, it's cause he's just bad. Okay. Got it. It's all become clear. He is just garbage. Knowing my luck, I can get hit. I'm going this. This gives me extra accuracy. Oh. Now, why do they have higher hit now? What? They have higher hit than... If, oh, because Healstone is 15. Okay. Well, Lear, do your thing. One of your MVPs? And Path of Radiance? And I feel sorry for you. Fuck that guy. Ina, please. Ina. Ina. Oh, my lord. You can't get... He doesn't promote in Path of Radiance. It's impossible for him to promote in Path of Radiance. There we go, Danved. There we go. Kill him. Kill him. There we go. Brom? Why? Why, Brom? What have I done? Good job, Sothe. Oh, that is... Oh, shit. Well, that's his Mega Blast attack. You to stay on Wardwood. Brom, you probably need Wardwood as well. Can go here. Micaiah can't move. Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna try and make my. Okay, mortals cannot stand against gods. Don't you see the futility of what you're doing? I'm just gonna do. Eight to Lyre, five to Sothe, four to Lucia, and none to Ina. Awesome. Oh, there's an open space right there. Shit. Well, Danved, can we not? He lives. Nothing else can attack him. Right? Yeah. He barely lives. That nice renewal. Crit something. I saw a bunch of cancels. Bunch of shit just popped up on the screen. I don't know half of what I just saw. Have Lyre start taking out all of the spirits around him. Let's do this. We get experience for doing this. We'll get a level. Can I kill him this turn? I don't know if I can. HP, great. Not really, but, you know. I was gonna say, like... These ones have to go. For sure. Like, Wardwood. Like, I just don't even kill you. -42 × 2. Why can't you do that to all the others? And you're nearing your S rank, yep. Oh my god, Lucia. Get like ultimate crit Astra, damage, adept, kill move. Yeah, you say that like Brom can just walk a mile. And Ike definitely is not doing the damage. Look at this man. He has 35 defense with 50 HP. Ike's not killing him in one round. No one's killing him in one round. Nice and five, yep. Okay. Concoction for... I gotta do it, though. Otherwise, he's definitely dead. Yeah, that's Kurthnaga. Ike is not Kurthnaga. Kurthnaga is the strongest character in the game. Ike is not Kurthnaga. Hey, Razdog, how you doing? I'm doing pretty good. The run is almost over. Moss, it is almost over. Also, hi, how you doing? I have a wall. I should be safe. Just see here real quick. Danved. Come over here and kill this one with Titania. Nope. Well, in that case... get to full health with Sothe and hope for the best, I suppose. Knee hill versus knee hill. Does that do 20 damage flat? Because that did 20 damage to Brom, who has like no resistance. Hello. Okay. They're gonna gang up on Boyd again. I'm pretty sure he still has a few turns of ward left, and he's on a ward wood, so we are fine. Yeah, they're just ganging up on him again. Nowhere near as funny. That's definitely rending time. This is very true. Speaking of, he tried. Hello. Go here. No, let's kill you. And... God damn it, Titania. This is where Titania starts to be shit. Like, from the dragon level to here, Titania is garbage. You do not cut it. Whatsoever. Oh, look at this. This guy can double me for zero damage. Let's go. Oh, he's gone. We got Flare. Nothing like covering the entire field in lava to kill one little sprite. ...14 damage for you? Sure. If I don't use the extra range with Leo, I do. Might be a set damage distance attack. That's what I'm thinking. Must have really bad experiences then. Damage. Let's see. You have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright. Hit him up with the Wishblade. Come back. Finish him off with Kurth. Yeah, Leanne died a long time ago. And I just said, fuck it. Even though she'd be very, very helpful for the last map, but fuck it. No, Lyre, just do your super kill stuff. There it is. She got walked up on, and by two people. No, by one guy, actually. The Black Knight chapter. I can't do that. Well, actually, I could do that. There's no more roaming ones, so. Fuck it, just grab yourself a wardwood. From boy, grab concoction. Now I made a backup save. I still have that save. But I couldn't be bothered. I think, on the third reset. And I was already done with the game. Like, it was the last turn. The last possible turn. I was done. Hi. How many just spawned behind me? Because it didn't show me. It just shows one HP bar over there. Oh, two. Alright. They're just the fire ones. I don't know which ones are the strong ones. Oh, these ones spawned too. Okay. Well... start taking them out. Gone. Hey, Prince, how you doing? What have you missed? Well, all of Rune Factory. But we all you really missed of Rune Factory. Well, we did fight a boss. We had a disappointing Christmas. I mean, I guess it wasn't completely disappointing, because, you know, we got that first kiss, not just a kiss on the cheek. How do I want to do this? Can I kill you? Yep. And you are... okay, so... if I purge you, you do 14. If I hit... which I do. Rex Flame, that's not a kill. Titania, can you reach? You can. I start taking out this shield of... Yeah, went for the kill. Saw some room factory part, just didn't say anything. Oh, that's fine. Lurk. Lurk till your heart's content. But in terms of this, we haven't really had any dialogue. We did all of the dialogue to start this chapter in the last stream, so we've been... And I explained kind of like how this map works. Other than that, you didn't really... You didn't miss much. Oh. 23 damage to you, alright. Yeah, I need to kill this guy. I could see him causing issues. 3 damage, that is actually all I need. As long as I hit you, alright. Oh, we get flare, of course. Catches lava floor. We already know his name's Leron. Yune told us. It's not a spoiler at this point. Silver knife. Okay. Oh, wait, there's this dude down here. Can I body you? Not without some magic. I mean, if you're the only one who's really gonna move, I don't see too big of a problem. Just letting you live your goddamn life. We canceled that man. He was not hitting us back. Not today. Not any day. 000. So let's take out the back one because why not? Thought it was at the end. Nope. When he pops up, Yune calls him Leron. He's like, why are you calling me that? He's like, I renounced that name. Damage, might as well. Alright, Laura. Finish this one off. Never mind, you can't. Dude, 24. Hopefully you don't hit me. And we get Adept, so Sothe, oh, never mind. I was like, so Sothe gets the kill. No, he still doesn't. He still doesn't. Can I push Lucia? I can. Okay. Can you reach? Okay. Question is... Javelin won't kill. Damn. Hold it, Takumi. How dare you say my real name? Oh, yeah. Okay, I was gonna say, what are you... Like, did I say you could call me? Like, did I say you could talk to me? No? You have more resistance, so if anyone's gonna come out here, it's gonna be Brom. Luna, gone. Now, Takumi, there was dialogue either in a support or like in like chapter 5 or something. Have I seen the ending scene? No, and you should stop. Don't mention too much. I don't know who's here who knows the game and who doesn't. So better be safe just to not. Ooh, rescue, yeah, get him over here. Make him quick. Yeah, it's one of the earlier ones. He's like, who said you could say that? what? Excuse me? 10 damage, 7 damage, ooh. Yeah, you can chill out back there, I suppose. Alright. Let's hope all goes well. There's one who, I think only one can move, and then there's Sephron, probably gonna use his blast attack. You're also very flawed, flaws must be corrected. Yeah. Sephron blasty move. That did a lot. Why is this doing, like, holy shit. Oh my god. We might be in trouble. There's only one that can move, but still, holy shit. I don't have a 45 staff equipped. I wasn't gonna equip it until the next map. I guess let's just hope for the best. Vantage, adept, you still don't do damage. There, I'm back and not so. Welcome, how you doing, Black Nappa? Oh, God. Okay. I'm gonna battle save. I'm gonna see if I can take him out here. If I can, then we good. If not, rip dip. Alright, Lyre can absolutely take one of them out. Or not. Unless she gets rend. Or adept. You need two adepts to do it. Shit. Yeah, like, oh my god, Ike, please. Who has the physic? You have a physic staff left, alright. Actually, I'm gonna Matrona him. He's at his worst biorhythm right now. This one's day been so far. Slow. Kinda boring. Went to work. Put paint and other, like, just moved paint around. Okay, so 30. But that's only gonna matter if I can take out all four of these and then finish off. Let's see, 18. Okay, I can do 30 plus 20. Wait, that's how much I do, right? 30 plus 20? 30? Okay, between Kurth and Ike, we can kill him. But these fire spirits have to go first. And if we can't do that, we're fucked. Okay, damage Micaiah with the XP. I mean, I've started giving her some. And even that, you gotta hope she gets speed with her BXP. If she doesn't, she's still garbage. We have a chance. We have a decent chance to crit or get impale. We didn't get either. We got corrosion. That doesn't matter here. That does not matter here, Danved. Ooh, wait. I can't move Ina because I need to move Blood Tide, where Sothe is actually. So I need Ike here. Oh, I might have fucked up by putting Danved there. Maybe not. We'll see. We'll see. I don't think I can do it. I'm thinking I'm not gonna be able to. I could see if I get crits or lethality or some shit. Marcia. Let's see, Lyre. Can you solo one? Not without packs. Let's see. Okay. Awesome. Thank you, Lyre. I needed that. Marcia, I need you to kill one of them. I think I need her to kill the back one, because I believe between Brom and Boyd. How much does Kurth do without Blood Tide? Hold on. 13. Okay, so I need Blood Tide for this to work. So Ina needs to be like here. Can she damage anything? Just ones that really don't matter. Do it. Okay, thanks. Alright, so we got my Void. Okay, I think between Void and Sothe, I can take this one out. Okay. Marcia, actually, wait, shit. I might be kind of screwed. No, Marcia can take, okay, okay. Michael Karka, how are you doing? I have recently found you on YouTube, looking for Lunatic Runs of Birthright. The video's a lot. Just been watching your playthrough, was hoping I get to see you other your other firing games, since I've only played Awakening and Birthright. Well, I appreciate that you found them and that you enjoy it. That's great to hear. Welcome to the stream. Lunatic Birthright runs. I don't know if I will ever do one of those. But actually, after Radiant Dawn here is done, I'm doing a challenge run of Birthright. That will be strictly on streams. Ina's there. Nope, nope, Soft, you can't be there. You have to kill him from a side angle. Shit. Can Brom do it? Brom can do it. Okay. I think we good. We're doing a capture, a Corrin capture and capshi, if you want to say it that way, only run of Birthright. I think that's going to be really fun. All right, so average out. Yeah, she's nowhere near as bad as people say she is. Like 30 runs with this game. I've had her cap speed twice. But her speed cap's 30. That's not great. Alright, Kurth. You gotta land this. If you don't land, well, like, do we have 100% with Ike? We don't have 100% with Ike either, so... I mean, this game doesn't show the correct hit, so... And Michael, I don't know if I'm saying, is it Karka? Or is one of those C's like an S sound? Either way, thank you for that follow, I appreciate that. Let's just go. Let's go, Kurth. We hit him. Awesome. He's gonna use Critty Lod. Probably didn't say that right either. You ever gonna use Amiibos in a run of Fates? Not in the LP. I don't know. If we're trying to figure out something else, maybe we'll say I said it properly. Awesome. And we'll do like Amiibos only. If pot like a Corrin and Amiibos only. Fuck, I don't know. Alright. Let's get him dead. You can try to complicate things, Sephiroth, but it comes to this. You are my enemy. Nothing more, nothing less. So be it. And we're gonna get bopped by this. There's an 8% chance he got the crit. I just realized that. I would have been so upset. All right. At last, I'm dying. And there we go. He's dead. Isn't Kurth amazing? What a great. I mean, yeah. Yeah, but still, like, you only get him, like, for a few chapters.
Sephiroth, hold on. Open your eyes.
No, this dude, stop trying to be upset for this dude. This dude is the reason we're at war, all right? Sanaki.
Sephiroth, you can hear me? Somebody help, he's wounded.
I'm sorry, Sanaki. The doors leading to Ashira won't open while he's alive. I can't save him.
That's correct. Thank you, Yune. I'm sincerely grateful.
Death is all you've wanted since this started. Everything else has been a little more than a terrible side effect. I'm sorry that this was your only goal, but I'm happy to help you achieve it. Sephiroth, I see now what you were going through. It must have been hard. I wish I could have helped you.
Please, don't mourn for me. I'm not worth it. You're really not.
I'm so sorry. I wanted to help you. I really did.
Forget about me. This path was my decision. My tragic mistake.
Hey, buddy. Battle combo was completely different if you had gotten the Ike memory scene. Really? How do you even get that? Because what triggers the Ike memory scene? Because this is a second time around. I thought I would get it. Is the Ike memory scene built in with the Sephiroth flag? Like, is it like... I don't know.
Lady Sanaki, I want you to have this. This is the Rudol gem. Wear it in memory of me. It will protect you. Please forgive me. I'm sorry I lied to you.
You ain't sorry.
Sephiroth, don't worry. We still have all the time we spent together. Nobody can take that away. Nobody.
Thank you. I'll be leaving you now. Sergius is waiting.
Second playthrough. But see, that's the thing. Like, this is the second playthrough. So there's something. There's a flag that I didn't set. I get that. Because we have Peleus. Ike and Black Knight. Okay, that flag. What consoles do I own? GameCube, Wii U, and a PS3. And that's it. I believe it's built into recruiting him. Ah, okay. Ashira is waiting just beyond those doors. Let's go. You're close. If you had encountered the Black Knight on the river chapter, you would have gotten it. Well, shit. I don't think, I'm pretty sure it wasn't possible, because if I remember correctly, we didn't have the speed to go up against the Black Knight and live. I believe we figure that out at the end there. Like, we would have gotten doubled by the Black Knight because of Ike's low-ass speed. So, doing it, I think doing it would have been impossible.
I'm sorry, Sephron. I once lost hope in the Lagoos and Bjork too. I can see now that my punishment was far too strict. I was young and naive, and so sure that I was right. I wish I could have shown you the error of my ways, Sephron. Loran, goodbye.
Sephron about to do some... And we got the root all gem. You don't need Arquin. All right. So let's get into the final battle of the game. We have another. Yep. All right. I will shut up. This plan.
Hear me. Goddess Ashra, Yune's imprisonment within the medallion has begun to change you. Order and chaos, you are one being, comprising both parts. The one must naturally affect the other.
Even so, I will not return Yune to this body. She is unstable, and I must be perfect in order to protect this world. It is as I have said. Yune must be destroyed.
Ashura, you mustn't. You cannot survive without your opposite. Please, you must not do this. Your world still needs you.
Leran, you have ever been a wise and kind-hearted child. In deference to you, I will place my faith in your For the next 1,000 years, I shall sleep as well. When I wake again, I hope it is to a world of peace and order, where all prosper as equals.
Awkward pause?
If I do, then I will know that you have advised me. I will reward your counsel. I will also allow Yune to return to me. I will once again be the goddess of creation, whole and complete. Ashunara, the Dawn Goddess, the name your ancestors gave me so long ago. I should like to hear it again. However, during this 1,000 years, if the chaos of war should arise and awaken Yune from her slumber in the medallion, I will know that you have strayed from your path, and I will punish your failure as I will reward your success. And then you will know my judgment. You will pay for your sins, each of you, to the last.
In the names of our people, we vow to keep this covenant. There will be no great war between Lagos and Bjork for 1,000 years. So pledge Altina of the Bjork, Degensia of the Dragon Tribes, Soen of the Beast Tribes, and I, Leran of the Bird Tribes.
If you believe during these 1,000 years that you have created a world that has outgrown the atrocities of war, or if you feel the world has fallen beyond hope of redemption, you may sing the Galder of Release and awaken us both. Your heirs will possess that ability as well. Sing to awaken us and tell us your tale. Tell us of the world your two kinds have built in our absence. We will listen. And we will judge fairly and impartially. This is our covenant with you.
Uh, Right, so Leron was a bird all along. Or, well, Sephiron. He was bird. But how you doing, Alex and Black Nappa? I don't have preference. Preference comes between person, like from person to person, I guess. And what each one looks like. Some ugly ass bikinis. Some ugly ass one pieces. But the opposite's the same. There's some really nice bikinis and some really nice one pieces. Let's see. Was someone like a grandfather of Kanigas? Yes. Much like Leron is pretty much the grandfather of all the birds. But anyways, it's her.
Ashira.
Also, they touched on Yune and Ashira. They touched on the last, like, memory scene that, like, they were kind of like two halves of a whole. Well, they actually were. Ashunara. You just throw their names together, you get Ashunara. And that they were just one person, but they split off from each other, and shit hit the fan.
Ashira, it's me, Yune. Can you hear me? Please listen to me. You don't need to pass any more judgment. You can return the people to normal.
I cannot. There are still people in this world who are made of fallible flesh. This imperfect world has passed beyond control. Now I shall pass my final judgment.
All the birds? Was it just the herons? See, like, they don't ever touch on all of them, but if it's not all the birds, then it would be just the herons. Because I don't think they ever really, like, they don't talk about a phoenix father or, like, a raven father. It's just bird tribes. So, I don't know.
But you can't violate the terms of the Covenant, Ashira. 1,000 years still hasn't passed. We were woken by Galdr, not by mankind's war.
It doesn't matter.
Damn.
During my long sleep, Bjork and Laguz continue to fight. The children of flesh will never learn nor grow.
All these birds, and where's Tristan? I mean, I don't think there's a fat bird in here. It's like Tristan's in a different game, yeah. he's in Rune Factory 4. We saw him today.
Time will pass as always, but nothing can change the destiny of mankind.
You have to look deeper. The first judgment didn't turn everyone to stone, and I'll tell you why. Because these people are not people.
Oh, we're aliens, da-da-da.
As we know them.
Ashira, these people have become something new. People, the Zunanma, are the only living creatures of this world that we didn't create. Animals evolved to become Zunanma, who then became Laguz and Bjork. That evolution continues today. Ashira, I'll tell you a secret you didn't know. Children can be born of both a Bjork and Laguz parent. There are still very few in number, but if allowed to flourish, mankind might become anything. If the two races continue to evolve, I'm sure something wonderful will emerge. You can't just bring that to a halt.
Do not claim certainty of anything. The children of this world are born of chaos, and nothing could be more uncertain.
The ravens and hawks used to live together, and maybe some herons lived with them as well. See, my thoughts for why possibly only herons was only the herons could sing the Galdr of Rebirth. That's true. Tristan did carry his job. Yes, he did. He killed himself a nice fire dragon. We need Tristan, we've got daddy. No, we killed him. Oh wait, I didn't read that one. Uncertain.
The world does not require the evolution of man. My responsibility is to protect order, the balance of all life forms. Beings that evolve without my guidance will only destabilize and threaten this world. Because of that...
You have to wipe out everything made of flesh? Is that what you're trying to say? Very well then. You and I have nothing more to talk about. My only choice is to defeat you.
Yune, do not be absurd. You cannot overthrow me, just as I cannot overthrow you.
Of course not, but they can. Everyone, the time has come. Defeat Ashira, or everyone you love will be a statue forever.
These people, they carry your blessing. Yune, you mean to fight me?
Ashira, our goddess, this is the world.
and we are the people you created. You make it sound as if we're some sort of filthy creature that just decided to settle down here and cause trouble.
Ike, don't say it like that.
We're not perfect. Sometimes our brains tell us one thing while our emotions tell us another. And war, the more we try to avoid it, the worse it is when it comes to us. People are probably the dumbest creatures alive.
But somehow you're also the most endearing. It's your imperfections that makes you so interesting. Imperfections very similar to ours.
We know that we messed up. We do our best to avoid more war and to make peace at highest priority. Ashira, just give us one more chance. All we ask for is one more chance. You expect me to reverse my judgment? The Goddess of Order cannot be so mercurial. My decision is final. We have got Kitty Cat Man. I mean, but not really. We've got Lyre. So that's how it's gonna be, huh? Then we will fight. Oh god, what did you say? Then we will fight. And we will save our people. Make your peace with whatever the gods worship. Your end is near. My end is near. In every battle that mattered in my life, I've always been the one left standing, no matter how slim my chances. This battle means more than any of the others, because it's for the life of every person that I've ever cared about. I will win this fight. There we go. So, we have none of that. Support, do we get? All right, we getting B support here. And this is the final chapter, so if anyone dies, I don't give a damn. As long as we can still finish off the map, people can die all they want. Fortify, and I'm gonna give Laura Hammern, because I have a feeling I'm gonna need to use Hammern on the Fortify. Okay, that. Casually plays Exodia. What's up, guys? What have you missed? How you doing, Endless Prince? You missed the Sephiron level, but this is the final level. So you got here just in time for the very final level. Okay, Ike has Nihil, Micaiah. Can redirect attacks aimed at supported ally units. Let's see, you can still have Paragon, whatever. I think only if Micaiah dies here, does it matter? I don't remember. I'm trying to think if I need to give Nihil to her or not. Parody is good. Nullify does I don't think Nullify works against. It's enemy bonuses. Maybe it does. I don't know. But let's see. Who are our main attackers? Need Nihil. Leonardo, you do pretty. You do pretty well. Lyre, you can have Nihil. Lucia has parity. Pavis. I mean. Let's see. Oh, the scary part. That is power. Oh, let's see. Wait. That was Prince. Tough work. All three of us. I'm a bit confused there, but I think we're good there. We can give out the last bit of experience. I don't know who should get it. Maybe Kurth. No, let's get Kurth to 40. We'll get Kurth to 40, and I think I'm gonna give him Pavis. I'm gonna take his Paragon, give him Pavis. Magic luck HP. Okay. Okay. Alright. So Kurth maxed everything except for skill and magic. Let's see here. Skills, Sanaki, move Pavis. Move Paragon. He might actually need. I mean, Pavis might be able to do it.
Give Kurth and Ina ire. Oh yeah, I forgot about Satiri's, like, I completely forgot about Satori signs in general. Like, I was thinking they did, like, they already had it. Like, they were good, they didn't need it. Nope. Ire. Remove a skill. Nullify enemy criticals. Can... Sure, no, Fortune. Ina is not level 30. Can she still use it? Nope. I can get you to level 30, I guess. Give you ire. Even though I don't feel like you're worth... Actually, no, she's not worth the time, to be honest. She's garbage. Boyd, get to level 20. You can have level 20. Skill speed? Okay. If only you were using Soren so we could have gotten him and Ike to A support for the special combo here. Is this where it is? Is it before the map or after the map? And also, isn't the Soren Ike A support thing, like, A support from Path of Radiance transferred over into A support here? Isn't that how that one works? Because this isn't transferred from Path of Radiance. She got speed. Good job, Micaiah. Ina. There you go. Okay, I think items... I mean... What other staves do I have? Take another physic. I don't think... Does she do any status ailments? I don't know if she does or not. I have this Valora Tome, and I never used it. Physic. I have a restore. I have a recover. Okay. I think that's everything that we really need to do. So let's get the save and head on into our final map. No, that's different. Oh, okay. So you get a special one they have in this game. Oh, okay. Okay, so they're two separate. Okay. Got it.
Everyone listen carefully. In order to reach Ashira, we must first destroy the aura protecting her. Got it? Attack the aura.
All right, so this aura. It's Order Incarnate. 90 HP per aura. This is where not having Leanne is probably going to be really rough. they have weapon rank of everything, double S, but they have Aurora, which causes half of all damage received to be reflected back upon the assailant, which means everyone who doesn't have, like, Nihil, Parody, all that, is going to take half of the damage they deal straight back at them. Let's see, so wait, are we fighting a god? We are fighting a god. We are fighting the god of order, the goddess of order. Who has 120 HP, also has S rank. Her weapon is Judge, a 50 might weapon, the miraculous power of the goddess. Her attacks have myriad form and effect. And these are her stats. Nowhere near as strong as Daddy Dragon, Degincia, but she's still no one to fuck with. So, let's get Kraken on, let's see, Healstone, Wardwood. Get Kraken on this here aura. We do have animations for attacking the aura. I might turn them off, because this is just the aura. But we do have a special looking animation thing. You know. please hit. So, when can we fuse this god? What clan? Damn. I don't understand this, but like, how the fuck do you miss an aura? Well, I guess it's the same thing. Like, how are you actually hitting an aura if it's like a gas thing? This is gonna get rough. Yeah, this is gonna be harder than I thought, actually. Who else has the skills? I know Lucia does. I can do 30 here. And can we make a burp? If only. But fun fact, I mean, we're past the level, so I'll go ahead and say it. If we would have, like, there was a way to recruit Leron, so you could have had him in this last chapter to join you in the fight. I believe he uses dark magic. All the auras have a mantle, too. Okay. I want to take at least one out per turn, if possible. ~42%, let's go. We hit it! Yes! And then there's the Aurora. Thought I missed the arbitrary and terrible intangible that deep. Yeah. Yeah. Don't shove. Don't rescue. Become a dragon. Clear. You also need to become a dragon. Or not become a cat. Be great if you could be a dragon too. That'd be cool. Okay, I can do this, and I can back away. We're gonna take some of this damage, though. Okay. Marcia has even better stats than the Black Knight, barring defense, and uses all magics, staves, and comes with the only Ashira staff. Yeah, I knew he came with the Ashira staff. Marcia? Can anyone do that amount? Liquidator? 45%! Come on. We landed at 42 with Micaiah. Let's go, Boyd. Liquidate it! Yes! We're gonna take a nasty hit. But we did it. Oh, no, we're not, because he dies. Okay. All right. That's on Wardwood. Okay. All right, let's see. Sanaki, do some damage. Get your head out. All right, Kyle. Thanks for sticking around. I appreciate it. Have a good night. Three damage. Oh my god. Let's see, why are bows your favorite class? Just curious, because I know a few people who avoid using that class. I really like bows. Like, it's not just a Fire Emblem thing either. Like, in most games, if I have the option to use a bow, I will pick the bow. I just really enjoy bows. Let's just sit there. There we go. Just need to hit to pass the wish blade back and forth. Converse with Lucia. Do it. You, Lucia. Why am I reading this? These are actually garbage conversations. Let's do it. We'll take 5 damage. Does the boss just sit there and not move till the auras are gone? Not move, yes. But she does have attacks. We will see them. We will absolutely see them. Oh wow, Sothe. You're gonna get bodied by the recoil, so I'm just gonna sit you there. Alright, enemy phase. So, they do heal, which is the worst part. They do, the auras do heal. I forgot that they could heal the auras. I completely forgot that they could do that. Okay. As long as I'm taking out one aura a turn, I'm pretty... I'm pretty good with that. Alright, so here's her first attack. It's blue. Ow. I think that was a magic. She has a magic and a physical. Let's see. Or that might have been physical. I don't know. But it does a shitload of damage. Which is why we have the Fortify Staff. Okay. Birds can't heal very much or else they die. Oh, well, that's what I thought, but, like, they didn't lose any of their health, so I was not entirely sure. Alright, Kurth. 25 damage. Let's do it. And Leanne is dead. Because Rayson and Raphael, why'd you have to kill? I mean, Rayson and Raphael didn't matter. Leanne was the one we were taking in. But it's still a shame that they're dead. Please hit. Please hit. Please hit. Fuck off. You missed twice. Twice. Leonardo, you shouldn't be missing. You of all people should not be missing. You 6 damage if you hit me. How perfect. Brom, can you come kill this dude? Can you give him? No, you can't. Titania? Brom, just give him an Oprah. Of course I get soul on the second hit. Okay, can I do damage with Vladimir? 11. I might just kill these guys off. I don't know. I think I can kill one of these off. What do you think of this final boss? I really like this final boss. Of the Fire Emblems that I've played thus far, and I've fought the final boss of thus far, because... You know, Birthright's still definitely a contender. This is my favorite boss. I think it's not just like Fire Emblem 1 and 3. 3 was a joke. Especially because I had the again staff. 3, it was one turn. It was one and done. 1, I mean, there's not a whole lot nice you can say about 1 to begin with, but I can take 12 damage, I can take that. It wasn't a challenge. Most final boss, like Grima, also not a challenge. All these final bosses who aren't actually challenges, it's just like, why? Why? Let's see here. Danved. Kill this spirit because he's in the way. Yeah. Stab the fuck out of that spirit. Team damage, okay. We're gonna play another game after this. Tonight? I don't know. Probably not. But it depends. But I'm definitely gonna, like, replace it, yeah. What skill does Lyre have? Nihil. Let's go, Lyre. Let's go. Kill it dead. Yeah, Grima is easy as hell. Ashnard himself was easy, but it was the fact that his map was a normal map, like with enemies everywhere. Other than that, Ashnard wasn't bad. Okay, so 2 down, I'm definitely gonna heal. Most of the Fire Emblem final bosses aren't challenges. Yeah, I do know about that. Oh, yeah. Get killed, little spirit. I do know that most of them aren't challenges. I've heard plenty about that. Alright, Micaiah. Fortify. And then Micaiah herself needs healed. So, heal her. And I don't know if I'm gonna even bother attacking another one, because it's just gonna get healed up to full. So, gonna end. I like the challenge that came from this. Yeah. Oh, from his map. I mean, they weren't easy enemies, that's for sure. But, like, it wasn't, why are you looking at Boyd? You would face me in battle? I need no further evidence of your kind's imperfections. This will hardly be a battle at all. Simply an end. Perish, flawed one. Hello. Let's not kill him. Or do. No, we gonna rock. We gonna rock.
No, I'm sorry. This isn't Big Brother Rolf. They're dead. They're dead.
Sorry to burst your bubble, boy, but they've been dead for a while. Alright. The ones on a wardwood tile are gonna be a lot easier to take care of. That is 48, okay. Actually, yeah, just take it out. Just play in hard mode to get the Berserk Ashnard. I don't remember what you mean by that. I didn't play in hard mode, so I'm... let's see. I body this. So let's actually get a hit. I was like, a cheek. I don't know what you mean by Berserk Ashnard. Okay, we might actually be able... Let's see, 30. I might be able to take out this aura as well, because it's... Wardwood... Or the ones on Wardwood are easy to take down. Okay. Over here with Ike for support. Verse. Alondite. Oh, I didn't parody. I didn't parody. We're gonna take damage. Shit. Should hopefully be fine, maybe? Just wanna kill. Ooh, I have to hit that though. Final form of action are more powerful. We did hit that. So like, the default Ashar, cause I was pretty sure like he went mad right at the end, doesn't he? I don't know. I'll watch it later. Okay. Let's see here. Yeah, I know she has it. I just forgot. That's what I said. Whenever I did it, that I forgot. Alright. And there we go. Okay, so we got two of them down that turn. Awesome. So we got four left. What is it? Oh, this one's also a Wardwood. Is it possible? Ooh, it might be. It might be possible. This does 46. 46. 67. And then... 87. Let's just not even go there. 87. Yeah, I can take this one out. As long as I don't miss, anyways. Okay. This takes it down to 3 HP. Got soft kill that one. I already used him. He was the first one to attack. He did the initial 46. All right. So we got three left, right? Yep, three left. Okay. Do I want to use fortify? No, I just want to make sure Soth doesn't die. Let's move right here and kill off. He's on Wardwood. Shit, of course. Okay, I'm just gonna end. Okay. Which attack is Ashir gonna do this time? Single target, or a blasty move? Okay, blasty move. So we definitely use and fortify. No one should die. Oh my lord, Lucia going down to 3 HP. So it's like no one should die, as Lucia almost dies. Hello. Alright. All of the health regen. Oh my god. Please. Okay. I think I want to take the covers. I mean, the cover ones take a lot more effort. The wardwoods are easy to take out. The ones, the two on the covers. So... Oh, well, guess I'm staying here. 24 damage. I will live. I will live. I'm gonna make sure I live the backlash. You have the Valora, or Rexora, yeah, okay. Over here, 22 damage, yes. This is kind of risky to do. Oh, this is really risky to do. I probably shouldn't have done this. How much HP does Micaiah have? Oh, she has enough, okay, never mind. She has enough health. I was just wondering, like, because Fortify heals everyone except for her. So I was kind of freaking out that I would use Fortify, she would be killed off in the next attack. Okay, 19 more damage. So we gotta do 25. That should be doable. Okay. Oh, yeah, just do it. Do it, Titania, do it! Okay. And that's a wardwood, so we all switch there. Put Ike on this wardwood. Don't miss this. Don't do this. Thank you. Okay, so we got one cover and one wardwood. I might... Let's see, can I take out the wardwood right now? I'm gonna take nasty damage there. Peshkatz. 30 if I hit. Go here. Parody. So I do 30 here. I have parity, so I'm not gonna die. And let's see. Leonardo, where are you at? Oh, you already moved Leonardo. I have Lyre. 48, okay. Is Anna worth bother? Not really, no. Over here. 16 times 2, that is death for me. Got it. Wishblade. I'm gonna go for this one. Okay, we hit it. We hit it. 43. I feel like I can do that. I feel like I can do that. Well, ooh. Maybe I can't, because I have to do... Oh, shit. Let's go in with Marcia. Let's use the Wishblade. 25. Okay. And with Kanto, I could go away and then finish it off with Lyre, and I should be good to go. Yep. Awesome. Actually, Lyre could have done it without even using Marcia. Alright, we got one aura left. Stone. Let's go on another heal stone. Fortify. Alright, Micaiah gets a level. Why did I think anything different would happen? You know what? Do it. Maybe you'll get crits or something. I don't know. He didn't. Get Kurth over here. Nina. Alright. So far, only Boyd has gone down. Oh, Danved. Oh, Danved. Okay, that missed. Swole. Danved, don't do it. Don't. Oh, okay. Okay, you only took 10 damage. That's not that bad. You're gonna take some more though, because he's definitely gonna hit you, unless you dodge. Dodge it. Okay. Sauce being single targeted. Okay. 38 damage. Fun. Okay, we have one more cover. No den of bears must live. I was not gonna reset if he died there. Okay, so let's see here. Wishblade, 15 damage. And then I'll back way over here. Vladimir, 11 damage. Let's try this way. Ishkots. 10 damage, okay. I know. Trust me, I know. I was gonna mention that after the auras are dead. Because there's no point mentioning it right now when we can't attack her. I've said like many times to you, Prince Pancakes, this is not the first time playing through this game. Alright, 25 health. Well, I'm not even gonna chance that with Leo, so let's kill this guy. Yeah, it works. One damage. Oh, if I hit, goddamn. Lyre? Let's just hope you hit. Why'd I expect her to hit? It's Lyre. At any time, like, I need her to do amazing, she doesn't. Alright, Laura. This isn't my second, this is my third. Oh, you're right, Prince. Don't forget to kill the auras. You're right. Alright.
The aura is gone.
Excellent. Now we can finish this. I want to be on Wardwood when I attack her. Alright, so this is the shitty part about attacking her. Our hit is hot garbage. Oh, it doesn't help that we are at the lowest portion of our biorhythm that we can possibly be. I don't know if I want to bother doing damage to her right now. I kind of want to see if I can one round her. You know, I don't know if it's possible though. With these units. How many fortifies I got left? 3? Alright. And you don't reflect back damage. No, you just have mantle. Oh my god. Okay. I could use Matrona, but I'm thinking I kind of just want to go for it. Because I think I'm just going to do damage to her. And then fortify after. Heal everyone's damage. I think that's what I'm going to do. Time to attack DOS. Time to hit lowest fire than review. Pretty much. Alright. Nihil versus Nihil. We hit. 46 damage on the return. Okay, we hit one. I'll take it. Irvin. She would just heal. She heals like 60. 20 per turn. Oh, I do remember that. Alright. I'm do like all the damage possible. If I can make any sort of progress, it's worth it. Because 4 to 5 will fix all the damage I'm doing right now. Vladimir, 29. Mm-hmm. 23 times 2. That is 46. 37% hit. Let's go, Ina. Do we hit? No. I would be so surprised if we hit that. Brom? How you doing? Did you see an Oprah? This is really nice if I hit that. Fates, we don't. I was like, I'd be missing 100%. Yeah, if this was Fates, none of these, I wouldn't have landed a single hit. Come on. Oprah, don't fail me. Yes, Oprah didn't fail me now. Now, I gotta hope that Kurth hits. Because if she does heal 70, she heals a full. Kurt does a nice 25. Yes, Kurt, yes! And if we had Leanne, I would go for the kill. Alright, gotta go, Polo. Sorry, couldn't stay to the end of the game. Alright, Prince Pancakes is fine. But thanks for sticking around, I appreciate it. Have a good night. Yes. I will do this. Go as low as possible. So 23, if it's, even if she heals 70, I think we'll still be able to do it, assuming we get everyone to hit. We're not the chosen ones, we're given the rod and die. Yeah, let's go, Danved. Let's go. Den of Bears. No Den of Bears today. Okay. Fortify. And Sothe is the only one who hasn't moved, but I can't attack her even if I wanted to. She only healed 52, so she has 75 health total. Not bad. Not bad at all. So I believe this will be the turn, unless we get the shittiest RNG possible. I'm all bullying Titania. How dare you? All right. Oh, a silence across the board. That actually doesn't matter because it only hit two people. Oh my god. 24 times two. All right. Knee hill. I'm gonna battle save just in case. Just to be safe. Just to be safe. Something dumb's gonna happen. So, you know. Better be safe than sorry. All right, Lyre. Lyre fighting a god. Man. All right, 27. How much is Ike gonna do? Ike can kill right now if he hits. I would rather only have to land one hit. I could Matrona, but I still only, like, I want one hit to be able to finish her off. So, Kurth, take her down to 2 HP for me. Please. Yes, alright. We Matrona. We definitely using the last use of Matrona on Ike. There he is. All right, Ike. What is your final level, Micaiah? Shit till the end. Got it. Yeah, we got it. We got this. Here we go.
We have to put an end to this. Take all the power I have.
Thank you. I'll use it well.
We all powered up now. Bop. Bop.
What of you? Are you leaving?
I am. But I believe it's for the best. This world does not need gods. We have always failed you. We've made you weak. That's why we must go.
You don't have to leave. It's true. We don't have much use for gods. But well, you show us what we should aspire to. We need inspiration. You give us a reason to grow, to become more than we are. And if we don't have that, Yune, we're nothing more than statues.
Hey.
Can you forgive me for the pain I've caused?
I don't know. But you have already forgiven us. How could we not? We are all family. We will try to understand one another, even when we disagree.
You're right. I will try one more time.
Time to save everyone. Watch them all just start fighting each other like nothing ever happened. Like, let's pick off right where we left off. Fuck this guy. I'm gonna stab him in his fucking furry ass face. Fuck fighting, I need nap. I was in the same position. I don't know how long the time span is between the time they're turned to statues until this point. But, I mean, you're standing in the same position for that long. You can need nap, you can need stretch. In that time period, my controller died. Use the last juice to do it, at least do that. Do I have anything that would work? Take the batteries real quick, I don't know. I think it did this whenever I beat the game on my channel too. Like, I remember the batteries of my Wiimote going out at like an awful but like great time. So they need a nap and some good liquor. It's been a week or so. That's what I would think, like, at least, like, 3 to 5 days. Well, the light's still on, so let's see. We're gonna talk to everyone who's still alive, which is not a lot. Well, I guess this is over. We'd better be on our way. Are you going back to Dayan?
Yes, everyone's waiting for us.
I have to start rebuilding all over again. Hopefully this time will be the last time.
No, don't say hopefully. Make it the last time. If anyone can do it, you two can.
I don't doubt it, but thanks for the vote of confidence.
Thank you, Ike. I won't ever forget you.
So the Priestess of Dawn, Micaiah, and auto-scrolling text that scrolls slower than every reader ever, crowned the 15th Queen of Dayan at Prior King Peleus' entreaty. Micaiah ushered in a new era of prosperity. And the Zephyr Sothe, becoming Queen Micaiah's husband, think about that real quick, and her pillar of strength, Sothe worked tirelessly to assist the poor. Edward, dead. That's count number one. One dead. Leonardo, Freedom's Arrow, Leonardo. Leonardo toiled at rebuilding the army with his proven skills and good looks. He was beset by women across Teleus. Is this like the awakening? Hold on. It's like the awakening where everyone speaks. Like the main group speak in between this. It's like part of the, like this. But real quick, Sothe married Micaiah. Like, okay, you know, like they look the same age. They've been together like for such a long time. It makes sense. But also, Micaiah, I don't know how old she already was. I don't know how old she is now. But she looked the same she looks now when she met Sothe, who was a tiny little boy. And she married it. Whatever. I'm just gonna keep going. So Nolan, that's death number two. Killed in part one. Laura, making it all the way. Carefree Saint Laura. Laura returned to her home's church and became a mother to many orphans, all of whom loved her gentleness. Rip Ilyana, there's number three. Killed also in part one. Micaiah the Cougar. Cougar on the prowl, yep. Heron, gone also in part one. Did Taronio die? Taronio did not die. He was one of the few lucky ones. The steadfast rider Taronio. Taronio worked tirelessly for his country as linchpin of Dayan's military and a pillar of statesmanship. Zeharc, killed. That marks five. Didn't we make our own canon that Micaiah is 80? Close enough, something like that. Jill, killed, also in part one, but, I mean, Zeharc made it to part four. Har, actually dying, he made it to part four. Fiona, dead, like, immediately. That's number eight. Oh, she actually made it to part three. Okay. They thought of each other as siblings. That they did. They thought of each other as siblings, but it's Fire Emblem, and it wouldn't be complete without incest, of course.
I'm sorry. But that's... I don't believe you. Because, see, my dear, you have the mark. Wait.
Oh, okay, so... They cut off the... He just told Almeda that he's not really her son. I will touch on who really is afterwards, if you want to know. Otherwise, I'll keep silent. It's up to you guys. Because I know who really... I know who her son really is.
Wait, don't you have a mark?
No, Mother. Lady Almeda, is that the reason you thought me to be your son?
I...
And that is the reason why Izuka chose me out of all the children at the orphanage.
Stop, this is impossible. You are my son. I'm your mother, and I say so.
Lady Almeda, your only memories of your son were him as a baby. You yourself said so. In other words, he already had a mark, even as a child.
Yeah, so what? What of it?
This mark, my mark here, is called the Spirit's Protection. When I was 13, I chose to make a pact with the spirits.
I would like to know.
All right.
What? When I learned that you were one of the Dragon Clan, I began to doubt, and slowly my doubt turned to certainty. I'm sorry, Lady Almeida. I'm sorry that, though it was never my intent, I ended up deceiving you. I'm sorry, but I am not your son.
Peleus.
But still, I was happy. It was fleeting, but I knew the feeling. I knew the feeling of a mother's love. You have my thanks.
So Peleus, did he die? Severely wounded. Death. I'm gonna count severely wounded and backing away as a death. Nayla actually dying, which was insane because she got put to sleep. So that marks 10. I don't know who the real kid is, not this whiny emo bastard. Volug. Marks number 11. So, we know everyone. We pretty much know out of all the characters who's branded and who's not. Branded, if you don't remember, means that they were born of one Bjork and one Lugu's parent. There is one person who fits that bill in terms of having a mark that was clearly visible. I have a feeling of who the kid is. I have a mark of clearly visible and ages very slowly, which is why he looks so youthful, but he was also orphaned very early. I don't know if we know this because we didn't really keep him around, but it is Soren. Soren is the true heir to the throne. He is King Ashnard's son. So the real prince of Daeon would be Soren. But he was cast aside because Ashnard didn't want any part of him, and so he was orphaned by birth. He doesn't know that he's royalty. I think the only way you get that scene is with the moving from Path of Radiance, your save file with A rank support between Ike and Soren, moving over here. Also recruiting Laron, or maybe recruiting Laron in itself does it. I know Laron has to say it, though. I thought it was the dragon guy. No. The people who can actually turn into dragons, they're not branded. The branded can't actually transform. They have blood of Lagoos, but they can't use it to transform. I believe it's brought up in Path of Radiance that he was orphaned. Maybe that's where the orphan portion came from. But it is Soren. So this whole time could have had a kingdom. Raphael, number 12. Killed off in a part 3. Kanigas!
Ah, Ike, your work out there was superb.
Hey, you aren't quite over the hill yet yourself. You know, I always wanted to go one-on-one with you, just once. You'd lose. You would lose, Ike.
Ha! I would have expected you had your fill of fighting.
I've had enough kill or be killed to last me a lifetime, but something simpler, some way of testing our respective strengths. Funny how similar Soren and Kurth look. Yeah, Soren has, like, the black hair. I don't know, does he have red eyes? I don't know what color his eyes are. But pale, very youthful, and black hair, long black hair.
You mean controlled matches with all the little rules they have? In a peaceful world, we need such things, especially we Lagoos. Without a fight now and then, we go a bit strange in the head.
That's the honest truth. Rather try to order a river to change course than stop a bunch of rampaging Lagoos. He wouldn't have wanted to be king anyway. So Kanigas, the fearless Lion King Kanigas. Upon returning to Gallia, King Kanigas lost no time in abdicating his throne. Countless songs still tell of his valor. Gifka, the Lion King's shadow, who never saw the field. Since their youth, Gifka had been ever at Kanigas' side as his loyal shadow. He died proud of how he spent his life. Skrymir! Skrymir didn't die? Oh, okay.
I kind of thought he did, but... The Fang of Gallia, Skrymir. Skrymir, as the new Lion King, patrolled Gallia's borders vigorously, and his large heart won the love of his people.
Kitty Cat Man, who also didn't die, the friend of nations, Ranulf. Ranulf was often run ragged by advising the new king. Oh god, yeah, being Skrymir's advisor? Holy shit, what a job. While he winced at his duties, Ranulf still indulged Skrymir. Leith! Dead. Mordecai didn't die, though. Leith did. The kind-hearted warrior Mordecai, after returning to the forest, Mordecai avoided battle and lived all his days in peaceful harmony with the trees. He lived with the trees. Lyre, the finder of secrets. What? Can I just say, Lyre, amazing. Absolutely amazing. She put in so much work being what I thought to be the worst unit we had drafted. Oh my god, why? Why? I don't know if you guys have said anything, but apparently my chat disconnected itself. So that's fun. I'm gonna refresh the page. Okay. Let's see. Oh, okay, it loaded. Let's see. Leith died because she was no powerhouse. Lyre's a savage. The stream is gone. Oh, the stream was gone too? Wait. Is this still gone? At least you're not Leanne. Like, let's see. Well, dead. Skrelp. Am I the only one? Is it? Because I'm alive. I'm here. Talking about how Lyre was supposedly bad. Is that the last thing? Oh my god, that's perfect, actually. Talking about how Lyre was supposedly bad. I don't know if you can hear. Can you hear me right now? It's back. Okay. You were talking about how Lyre was... That is great. That is great. It's like, bad. I'll show you. Okay. Kaiza. Dead. Sanaki. Audio is cutting out for you. Now it's good. Oh, the speed looks fine. I'm watching the speed. I don't know why it died. Maybe it's a Twitch thing, because my speed is perfect. Normally I can tell when my speed drops, and I'm like, okay, we got problems. But we should... All right. This is something that if you haven't figured out yet, you're going to.
Wait, sister! You're my older sister, aren't you?
No, what do you mean?
It makes sense. All the pieces fit. The Calder of Release. The goddess Yuna's voice.
It's true. Inside the tower, I heard the voices of many hearts, and I knew. I'm descended from Laron and Altina. Misaha, the former apostle, was my grandmother.
Yes, I thought so. In that case, my sister, please consider staying in Binyon with your power and charisma. You could do so much good here.
No, I'm afraid I can't.
Well, why not?
Dane is my home, and Dane needs me to help it heal and rebuild, not Binyon.
But Binyon!
Binyon has you, Empress. You'll be a just ruler. Make your country proud to have you.
Will I never see you again?
Hardly. I think that what our countries need now is a sense of family and friendship. I ask that you sign a treaty of alliance with Dane and announce that we are equals.
I will, of course. Once things settle down in both our countries, that will be the first thing I do. Sister!
Thank you, Empress Sanaki, my dear little sister.
So, the true apostle the entire time was Micaiah.
Can you talk about Lyre? You started it and then it cut off.
What did I say about Lyre that wasn't heard? I don't know where it cut off. Like, I don't know, I mean, just to recap, I thought she was going to be our worst unit, and she turned out to be one of our best units. It was crazy. She, actually, because of this run, she is in my top three for favorite Lagoos and favorite, like, shapeshifters in general. She's great. And she was a bad character and then turned into a savage. Yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. Like, she wasn't I thought she was gonna be our worst unit. She ended up being our best, like one of our best. And our worst unit was probably Brom. If you're not counting Micaiah being a complete nutter shitlord, but she's also forced. If you're not counting forced people, I think Brom ended up being our worst unit. Which, Brom being our worst unit isn't that bad. It's not that bad. But the Holy Empress Sanaki. Sanaki elected to guide her people in a world without the goddess and made treaties uniting the continent. But also the little tidbit there with Zigra undead, that makes 15, with Micaiah being the, you know, like a true apostle. It also explains, like, she's branded. You don't know really who, like, what branded she is, but all throughout the game, you pretty much can figure it out. But if you haven't, she is a Heron. She has Heron blood, which, in the prologue, she speaks the same language as a Heron. And then I don't think she ever does it ever again. Tanith, rip. There's nowhere near as bad as Brom. She could kill things with Thani. See, that's the thing. That's Thani. That's a super effective weapon. Brom can kill things without a super effective weapon. And with Luna and Oprah, he can sit there, live for days, he can dish out damage, while he may not always double. I would say he's better than Micaiah because he doesn't have to rely on a super effective weapon to get his kills. Tormod, dead. The Oprah is powerful. You can't underestimate the power of Oprah. Morum, also dead. Vika, also dead. Stefan, is he dead? Nope. Lion-blooded. Oh, this is where people say he has the blood of a lion. Because of this title right here, Lion-blooded Stefan. So he is branded with lion blood. So Stefan gathered like-minded individuals to form a tiny independent settlement, which later became a great country. Tabarn. But he couldn't double. He couldn't, but it doesn't matter when you can still get the kills. Oprah's. It's a super effective weapon, but not like Thani is. See, will we be heading back to Gallia first?
We'll stop by Gallia, then wing straight onto Serenus.
Serenus? Why there?
The Empress Sanaki has kept her promise. Serenus will be formally ceded back to us. She said we may return immediately.
Ah, I see. That's good to hear.
Sometimes birds change their feathers. The hawks, the herons, even the ravens. We're thinking we'll all settle down together.
All this time, we've sorted ourselves by our ways of thinking and seeing and living. If we can respect each other's opinions and we can learn to compromise, we can't learn to live without each other. We can learn to live together without strife.
I don't think it'll be that easy, but it still ought to be simpler than getting Bjork and Laguz to treat each other decently. You set a good example, Rayson.
All the major issues look like they'll be handled soon. The only thing we can't agree on is hunting and eating meat.
The forest creatures are off limits. Needless displays of violence as well. You know we will not budge on that.
Tell me, have you ever heard of a vegetarian hawk? What, a raptor that doesn't scream victoriously at the skies after a kill?
Meat, huh? That's a thorny problem. A country that doesn't need a name, apparently. I see you, Stefan. Yep, pretty much. So, Lord of the Air, Tabarn. Tabarn was chosen as the first king of the unified bird clans and brought them great respect from the other nations. The skies shadow Naesala. Saved from the Blood Pact, Naesala left his people and their nation. He became a diplomat, which is a very strange, like, Naesala becoming a diplomat, finding atonement and work. Very strange from everything we've seen from Naesala. This is like, really? Nah, fuck that. So Rayson is number 20. Janaf didn't die. Awesome, I like Janaf. The Hawk King's Eyes, Janaf. As the new king's right arm, Janaf eagerly trained his men that he often skipped meals, weekends, and sleep. Buffering? What? I'm looking at, like, okay, I don't understand. Is everyone buffering, or is it just you? I know, like, the original thing was everyone. But, like, I'm looking at my speed. The speed is not having any issues whatsoever. Like, the speed is really good tonight. I don't know if it's Twitch. Like, let me check the Twitch support. It's fine for you. Understand? Let's see. What I don't understand is why they never showed Race and Leanne Raphael's father. I just wonder what... I think there's a picture of him. I forget his name. But I feel like there... Hold on. Now that you mention that. I believe the wiki has a picture of him. Maybe his... I think his picture might be from Path of Radiance, though. Let's see here. Aaron King. Lorazai. Where is the word Lorazai? Lorazai. Did I spell that right? Come on. Chop chop, wiki. Chop chop. Hurry the fuck up. Didn't find anything because I didn't spell it correctly. Okay. Lorazai. Oh, there's not a picture of him. I thought there was a picture of him, but whatever. He was, like, dying the entire time. It's all fine. It's just him. Perfect for me. All right. Awesome. Also, how you doing, Eats Duda? Okay. But Hawk King's ears, Oki. Despite being the new king's left arm, Oki still loves solitude, spending his free time in long, deserted locales. So, Leanne. Severely wounded. The only one... Nope. Never mind. I was about to say, the only one of our... of our team that died. Nope, there's one other. Nialucci, the wise old crow. Despite his age, Nialucci worked hard to restore the name of the Raven Clan. Every year, he set a new age record. So he's old as fuck. Man of many mysteries, Volke. Volke was really fun to use. I've never used him before. He was really, or in this game, I should say. I used him in Path of Radiance, but in this game, I never used him. Man of many mysteries, Volke. After finishing his contract, Volke went back into the shadows he knew so well. He was a man of mystery to the end. So, young Dragon Prince Kurthnaga. I just realized, yeah. Kurthnaga and Soren both have the mark in the same exact spot, too. There's another hint. Like, they both have a red mark right in the middle of the forehead. Kurthnaga spent his days arbitrating conflicts between nations, guarding the peace so many had died for. The Wish Spinner Ina. Ina returned home and gave birth to her lost fiancé. That was something they only touched on once, and I still don't understand this. I do not understand this. So she gave birth to Rajayan's kid. Okay. Sure. Rajayan died, what, 2 years? Was it 2 or 3 years between Mad King Ashnard's war and this war? How long are dragons pregnant? Like, how did you give birth to the, like, not only did she get pregnant, like, at least there, Rajayan was captive from Ashnard for a very long time. So how long, I don't understand how she was pregnant from her lost fiance for... how many years? I don't know. A long-ass time. Ridiculous. But Goldoa rejoiced at the first dragon birth in centuries. Wasn't it only at the end of Path of Radiance that they bring that up? I don't know. I just remember at the end of Path of Radiance, I felt like it almost seemed like Rajayan lived. And then this game says he died. Because if Path of Radiance was the end, I would think Rajayan ended up living, that the Heron Galder saved him. But I don't know. Either way, she was pregnant for at least 2 years. At least. Crazy. Let's see. Will your majesty, shall we be off?
Yes, let us. To Crimea, to our homeland.
So the devoted queen, Alencia, did not go down. Alencia governed Crimea with resolve and a deep love for her people. Her reign was remembered as a golden age. Dragon baby be in the room like it's a party. So Grim Cavalier Renning. all Crimea rejoiced at Renning's return. He chose to forego the limelight, helping the queen. Helping the queen to keep the peace.
Jeffrey, I fight for propane and propane accessories. Protector of the propane realm, Jeffrey, as captain of the Royal Knights and a model of chivalry, Jeffrey served his queen and country all his days. Maybe he's not dead. He's just lost in the woods or at Walmart. Good point. Tireless advisor, Lucia. For the queen, this is the first time I actually used Lucia too. Wasn't too bad. But the queen went, Lucia followed. Their love was fabled to be stronger than even the most blood sisters. Poor dragons have to be pregnant for that long, though. Yeah, though dragons do live for a long time, so maybe the pregnancy is that long. That's what I'm thinking. Like, maybe because, like, it takes them... Like, Kurth is at least 100 years old, and he looks like he's, what, 15? So maybe they're pregnant for so long because, like, if they were a normal, like, 9-month span, they probably wouldn't be grown enough to live. So... I guess it makes sense, but still, it's ridiculous amount, like, years of pregnancy. So Crimea's keystone, Bastion. Bastion's unparalleled diplomatic skills ensured that many treaties were signed, spreading peace across Tellius. Kieran, we're back to the desk. There's another one. Marcia, the petulant Pegasus Knight, Marcia. Marcia showed her dedication as one of the Royal Knights. I think she was one of the only survivors. Ever vigilant as she patrolled Crimea's skies. Makalov, dead. Yeah, we're going through the Crimea Royal Knights. I think Marcia and Jeffrey were the only survivors. Because Astrid, dead. That makes 5, 10, 15, 20, 20. That makes 25 right there. Nephany, poor Nephany. I really, really like Nephany. Oh, man. Brom, the rural juggernaut Brom, returning to his family in Oma. Lucia and Alincia be doing. Returning to his family in Oma, Brom farmed for the rest of his peaceful life. He never lifted a weapon again. That's fitting for your stats, Brom. That's very fitting for your stats. The wayfaring country girl Meg, gone. Alluring rogue Heather, she lived pretty long. For just being a steel bot, she lived pretty long. But she'd gone. The lucky wayfarer, Danved. Fight like den of bears. The war over, Danved hung his lance and became a traveling performer. His act could make anyone laugh. I love Danved. Khalil, gone. If they were only 9 months in the womb, the dragons would eat all the food. Scarlet-haired paladin, one of my favorite characters in this game, Titania. Titania remained second in command of the mercenaries. Once a year, she visited the graves of her fallen friends. Deadly Adept Shinon, dead. More like Dead Adept Shinon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see. Perpetual Guardian Gatry, also dead. Agile Horseman Oscar, dead. I just realized all three of the green hair brothers died. Cause I couldn't keep Boyd alive in the last chapter. Rolf's dead. Oscar's dead. Boyd's dead. RIP. Just mass produced death machines. Boyd. The first time I've ever used Boyd, and he was really good. Like, I enjoyed using Boyd. I don't know why, I was just like, it's Boyd, throw him away. And I just bench him. Rolf, dead. Rise, dead. But Boyd was pretty good. I don't know if I got lucky with the speed or not, but having Adept was great. Mia, one of my other favorites, didn't get to use you, you're dead. Mist, dead. Soren. Dead. But yeah, there, you can see it's the same exact mark. He does have, yeah, red eyes, black hair, same exact mark as Kurthnaga. But he's dead. Ike.
No title for Ike. Once he saw stability returned, Ike left on a journey to land still unknown. He was never seen again. So, Boyd or not Boyd? I don't like Nolan either. So, there we go. We got the credits, and then we got the records at the end to see who our MVPs are. I'm excited to see that. But our final death total. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 36, 37, 38 dead was our final death count. Crazy. But like, yeah, I never use Boyd or Nolan, but I definitely like Boyd more. Like, they're both just people I bench. It's probably just like an axe user thing. Like, I just tend to bench axe users because accuracy. Like, if they're just an axe user, they probably get benched. If they can use other things and axes, you know what? Sure. Just being an executioner in this game. I don't think I've... Yeah, that I definitely was. Like, prior to this, I think the most I've ever lost, maybe 10... I don't know, I would have to go back to my Radiant Dawn Let's Play I did. I think that was the most deaths I've ever had in a Fire Emblem game. Well, maybe not, because there was a lot of, like, nobodies that died off whenever I did Fire Emblem 3 Book 1. You killed off less people than I thought. I thought you'd kill 50 units. Would that have been possible to kill off 50? I don't think that would have been possible to kill off 50 units... Well, unless most of my squad died on the last map. Otherwise, I don't think it would have been possible to keep the 11, or the, you know, the people we took in alive and everyone else dying. I still don't think that would have reached 50, but I don't know. When you killed Jill, I did kill Jill. She didn't make it past part one. Most people use Nolan due to his insane speed for a fighter, but non-existent strength. Best redhead with a dragon. I mean, redhead is always, it's always a plus. But, you know, he wasn't part of it, so cannot wait to see the Fates capture run and see how many units die. I don't know how I'm going to do that, because I do want to do all the paralogs with that capture run. Well, mostly because there are some captured units that can only be got through a paralog. So I'm going to have to keep people alive. But after we get their paralog, I can kill them off. But also, the capture run, we can kill someone and then just capture a new one. Like, just replace them. Like, hey, and Faceless Archer number 5. Sorry, you're being replaced by Faceless Archer number 6. Alright, GG, well played. Gotta sleep. Good day for you. Alright, it's Duda. Thanks for sticking around. I appreciate it. If you lurk the whole time, that's fine. Lurkers are mighty, mighty welcome. But have a good night. Thanks for coming out. 6% speed growth, or like 70 units in this game. I know there was a shitload. I mean, I never used Nolan or Boyd because they bork my game and freeze it whenever they promote. What? They really? Is that like a disc or an emulator? Either way, that's messed up. Like, I don't. Is the disc? If it's a disc, is it like really scratched? Is like those classes specifically that like were scratched on the disc so bad it crashes? It's a disc. Unfortunately, Radiant Dawn is not cheap, so it's not one you can just go out and replace without dropping a lot of cash. I got, this is my second copy of Radiant Dawn. The first one I bought, a friend borrowed and then never returned, and he moved away. I'd love to watch the Hoshido capture run, but I haven't played Hoshido yet. I mean, I'm not gonna start it until I've beaten Hoshido myself. So I kind of know what I'm gonna be up against, but I think I can knock it out before Monday. I don't know, we'll see. But I do know, like, because people haven't played, like, either... or waiting for Fates in general, or haven't seen half of the game, I do know spoilers are going to be an issue with the capture run, but I apologize for any of you who can't, who aren't going to watch because of that. It's only the fighters, apparently, probably when I left my brother and borrowed at some point. Not either, but I do not care about spoilers. Or was it just fun view? I'm really interested to get into Conquest. Or Conquest currently. Chapter 20 in Conquest is a bitch. I haven't heard that. I've heard 10. I've not heard anything about Chapter 20 though. 10 is the one I just hear constantly. But I try to steer clear of most Conquest stuff. For spoilers reasons. Conquest story is better from what you've seen. I mean, the Hoshido story so far, I think, is already better than Awakening. So, if it's better, as long as the story is better than Awakening, hell. That's awesome. Final spoilers, only on Chapter 11, you're only on Chapter 11 of the playthrough. Alright. Chapter 10 needs balancing. I don't know. The bits I've heard about Chapter 10 is that it's a really well-made map. It's just hard. Like, I've not heard people saying it needs balancing. I've heard that it's really, really well done. It's, like, it's laid out, like, nicely and not, like, dumb, like all of Awakening's maps. And some of Hoshido's maps kind of fall under the Awakening map category. But I've heard it's just really, really difficult. Heard Conquest story is worse than Hoshido's. Interesting. Was that the last of the credits? Yes. Yes, it is. As the controller did go out again, but I think this is auto-scroll. I don't think I have to press anything. Oh, yeah. In days long past, a young man strode the lands of Teleus. He was simple yet true, his deeds brave and noble. He reunited two races long at war and healed the heart of a goddess long gone mad. Ask any you meet, be they young or old, Bjork or Laguz, of a hero named Ike, and you'll receive a warm smile and a tale or two of faith, courage, and honesty. I have to press A. No, it's fading. It's black and white. There's the fin. There's the fiend. Do I have to press A now? I gotta turn. Okay. Yes. Okay. Records. All right. We can see the ridiculous amount of, like, the turn counts were insane. Like, right off the bat, we have 20s in part 1. We have 33 on chapter 7. What is the most turns I took? I'm curious. 38. We have a 40 on part 2, chapter 1. 47 on Jeffrey's Charge. 47 turns for that map. Holy shit. On his first try, albeit he prepared in advance. Oh, okay. But 47, I don't think I'm going to top 47. Everyone told him about it. Still made me feel like a crappy player. Chapter four came close with 44. But turn counts into the 40s. I don't think I've ever done that. That is crazy. All right. Unit records. Let's take your guesses. Who do you think are be our top three MVPs? I would love to say Lyre makes it in the top three, but I don't think she will. I don't think she's going to make it into the top three. I hope she makes it in the top five. But if she doesn't, it's fine. But as for who, like Ike, I think Ike is definitely going to be in the top three. Lyre, Danved, and Ike. Danved, really? I mean, he did kill a lot at the end, but I don't think Danved is going to be an MVP. I feel like Ike is definitely going to be there. Titania might be there as well. Lear, Ike, you don't know. Oh, I really hope. See, Boyd is there. Okay. Oh, well, he had 100... Boyd had 113 wins. So, I'm gonna write that down to see where he would place if he didn't die. 113... Boyd. I just like the Den of Bears. Couldn't think of the third fast enough. Are we still scrolling? Alright, Volke. Kurth and Volke were our last. So, Sanaki, Lucia. Danved is not there. Brom, Micaiah, Marcia.
Lyre? I didn't see Lyre yet.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Sothe made... Okay, Sothe is our fifth. With 135, so Boyd would have been... Boyd wouldn't have made it to the top five. Lyre with fourth. He didn't make it just shy of top three, but she made it to four. That is crazy. 156 victories. Oh my god. Leonardo. Yes. Yes, Leonardo. My bow buddy. 171 victories. So Titania and Ike, we've yet to see. Here's Titania, making it to number two. So number one is Ike. Hey, Lyre made it to the top five. She had her own fancy little panel. That is good enough for me. Yes, midriff. So Ike winning with 184 wins. Man, I'm just proud to have Lyre in the top five. That, she's the fourth. Number four best unit in this entire run was Lyre. Crazy. Crazy. My god. Clear save data, yes. I might as well save over this one. Because this clear data is clear one, so let's just redo it. There's no sense of me doing a clear two ever again. If I do one, it might as well be a clear three. Lyre, still my favorite. Lyre, Tabarn and Lyre are my favorite Lagoos in this game. And Tabarn, Lyre, and Tiki are my favorite transforming characters in Fire Emblem in general. Lyre rending time is the best. True combos, that adept into rend was the best true combo. Lyre for Smash. Oh my god, could you imagine how much shit that would be thrown? Not only is she a Fire Emblem character, not only she's one of the most hated characters, it's because she's regarded as, like, shit, and isn't very, like, just not popular at all in any aspect, but she's a furry. Like, she's cat girl. So much shit would hit the fan if that was favorite furry is Selkie. I might like Selkie more than Caden. I don't know yet. I have the paralog unlocked. I haven't done it yet. What about Kitty Cat Man? Renolf is okay. I don't know. I don't hate Renolf. I think I like Renolf more so because of the voice I give him. Other than that, eh. Lyre for Fates. Yeah, give me a nice spot past Lyre. Okay. Well, that ended at a pretty decent time. Not going to like 2 a.m. like we did on Monday. So I am going to wrap up the stream here. Turn off a second to Lyre for the cats. I mean, for the cat, what all cats are there? There's Anulf, there's Lyre, and there's Leith. Is that it? I can't think of any others. But yeah, Leith is definitely my least favorite. So Lyre, Renolf, Leith. Wait for Keaton in Conquest. I am excited, except for the RAR. Except for that fucking RAR. I'm excited for Keaton. But, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, I wanna thank you all for coming out and supporting the stream as you do. This was a fun run, and the majority of these choices were from you guys, so you all were just as much a part of this run as I was. Misty's Raiding Dawn streams. It was fun. It was definitely fun. But Fire Emblem's not going anywhere. We'll always try and keep a Fire Emblem game going over here. So we're gonna be gearing up for a Birthright. Wolf looks so ugly when training. Kind of was mentioning, they don't even look like wolves. They look like Asian lions, which is very true. Have I ever used Leaf? I have tried, yes. And not as far as Lyre, but I have tried to use Leaf, yes. We're gonna be gearing up for Fire Emblem Birthright captured units run. We're gonna be using Korin, we're gonna be using Orochi, and then everyone else is gonna be a captured unit, whether they have a name, or rather a face, or not, because there's some that you can capture that have faces. Most will not. So that should be a lot of fun to do. But yeah, I'm gonna take my leave here. Again, thank you all for coming out to the stream. And on Monday, hopefully we will be getting started with that Birthright run. Let me pause this. Or I can't. Okay. There we go. Okay, Yetis. Yetis, kinda, yeah. But have a good night, everyone.
Don't leave.
Wait. Did it freeze for anyone else? It's not acceptable. We gotta rewatch it. It froze. It's not okay.
Don't leave me.